This is the 2013 Jeep Patriot. It's a compact SUV, which means it competes with other compact SUVs like the Ford Escape, Honda CR-V, and Toyota RAV4, just to name a few, which is difficult because there's about 20 other compact SUVs in its class, so it's difficult to stand out. One way that the Jeep Patriot stands out is its boxy styling. It's a nice alternative to the rounded off shape of a lot of other compact SUVs. It's got the round Wrangler-esque front end headlights, which is a nice change. And it's also got a low price tag. This car, brand new, was priced a lot lower than other compact SUVs in its class, which is nice for people like me, who bought this last year, October 2016. I was able to get a compact SUV that was priced a lot lower, so it was great for me. This particular car has the 2.4-liter four-cylinder engine and four-wheel drive, which was great last year because this thing was a beast in the snow. And I can either activate the four-wheel drive by lifting the lever in the console of the car, and a light will come on the dashboard letting me know that's turned on, or I can just let the car do its thing, because it comes standard with traction control and stability control, so the car always knows that it's in trouble, and it can get you out of trouble. This car also has the 5-speed manual transmission, which I think is fun. I've driven the automatic version of this car, and it's not as quick if you don't have the 5-speed manual. This car actually handles pretty well. It looks like a big boxy tank, but it actually drives really smooth. It doesn't glide over bumps. I don't want to say that it's completely smooth, but it's not truck-ish where you feel every bump. It actually smooths them over pretty nicely. It also handles decently. I wouldn't go canyon carving with this car, but for what it is, it's not bad. When you get to the interior of this car, that's where you can see why this car was priced so low. The material is very plastic in this car, and this one in particular actually does not have power convenience. It has crank windows, manual locks, and manual mirrors on the sides. So that's fun. But it does have air conditioning. It's not very bad in here. Very soft material on the side of the door. Not so much right here where your hand's gonna sit, that's hard plastic. But other than that, it's pretty spacious in here. There's a lot of room, especially when you put the seats down in the back seat. You can fit a lot of stuff back here. This car gets about 20 city, 28 highway. So normally I get around 26 miles per gallon doing mixed city and highway driving, which is not bad, but there are certainly other cars in its class that do quite better. Overall, if you are looking for a compact SUV with pretty good room in the back, four-wheel drive, and if you don't mind having crank windows and manual locks, at least on the base model of this car, I actually recommend it. It's been a pretty good year of ownership so far, and I look forward to many more. All right, I think that's about it. That's my review of the Jeep Patriot. See you later.